Hello. Welcome. I thought today, seeing as I've still got no vehicle, is that good English? Don't think so, but I thought I'd film a day in the life on a very hot day. Now, a very hot day in Britain is, for me, is over 22. Well, today's 25, possibly gonna get more. Luckily, well, I've had to, firstly, I would have had a shot of a combine harvester at the side of the road on my way here. But to start with today, I've walked 30 minutes to get here. Half of it's uphill, slight incline, but enough to, you know, when you're already covered in a layer of sweat from getting up, it's doesn't make a lot of difference, does it? Then, luckily, the people I work for they know about me and the heat, so they've given me the task of going around all the field edges and meadows. There's two fields through there. This is the lower meadow, and there'd be the upper meadow as well as other places I could go, and just cut all the brambles that are overhanging and anything like hogweed that's flowering to get rid of. So, I was on a hot day, so as you can see, I've got a hat, and here's the stuff I've brought with me. I've got the barrow, obviously, for stuff, gloves and secateurs, and then I've got a purple string bag that has got a neck blade fan in it. It's also got a portable hairdryer that blows cold air. I have water and toilet roll for anything that may be necessary, because when there's lots of dust from the harvest, there's lots of sneezing and reactions, you know, mucally sinus reactions, let's say. So let's show you where I am at the moment. I'm making the most of lovely early morning light to get the shots. So I'm at the back of this first meadow, which I helped create, by the way. This wasn't a meadow, 10 years ago. So the first thing you'll notice is these, the brambles. There is a rose here, but it's the brambles, because they come down and they root. So I'm trying to stop that. So this is my first patch. But one of the things I have to do is I have to plan my route in order to use as much shade as possible. So I've already noted that behind that tree, the next one along, there are some nettles. Well, I know that a bit later on that sun will have moved to there, so the shadow of the tree will still be on those nettles, so I can pull them later. So I came up here because this, it's always better to do what's nearer in this case, because I can get this, take it to the heap, which is the bonfire heap, which is over there, and then go to places further away. Normally you'd start further away for certain other things. So you have to plan it. So I'm planning, I have to know what is going to be shaded as the sun moves around. You just have to do it, because otherwise you can get heat stroke. And I've had that many, many times. So I'm gonna crack on. Okay, a progress report, where you can see the difference. I've also done the brambles that were, the nettles that were there. I've cleared the brambles. This stuff, cleavers, this, is also known as punk, which is basically a dry material for lighting fire. And talking of lighting fire, I curl my brambles. This is what I've got out. I curl my brambles into what's known as faggots. I like put them into foot lengths. Now I don't cut them, I just fold them. And then the very end bit I twist around like a spiral to hold it together. And they can be fire lighting faggots. I've also got the nettles from there, and I'm about to get these nettles here and under the magnolia there and along the fence, and then I'll make my way out and back to the barrow. Well, if you're going to do horrid work, there aren't many better places. So I've done that, and I've got all the... You can see the difference, can't you? Hello, scuttling creature. Don't know what that was. But I've laid all the nettles behind, because that pile there, I'm not going to put it in the barrow. I'm going to get the cart later when I come back and do those. So now we'll move to the next field, which is known as the first paddock. Now, if you notice, I've got a new worktop with no holes. And the first thing I do when I use it is to go among blackberries, brambles and roses. So if you wonder why all my clothes when I'm doing a video from work have got holes in, that's the reason. So this is lovely under here. This is a Hungarian oak, part of an experiment, because of global warming and also because of what's happening to our oaks, which there is an oak disease. Now look at, can you see in that the little white heads? Can't think what that plant is. I know it. It's one of those on the top of the tongue. A bit like dandelion leaves, but thinner. Pretty sure it's edible. Well, you notice that my hat has a hat flap. Yeah. That's probably going to be in the title. But we're at the top here. That's to trap squirrels, because they ravage this place. They don't often go in it, to be honest. But so we're going along the hedge here, where I can see brambles already. So that's going to fill my barrow. And look, the hawthorn. It's not looking that great, is it? Lots of fruit is sort of shriveling on the tree, or even cooking this year. So fruit's going to be expensive. Well, we're going along this line. Obviously, I'm not cutting the ones with blackberries on, but these that are hanging over, and I'll have to contend with the rows. So I've done this bit to get, like, because I work in sections. So I'll pick a section and then I'll work, because I'm right-handed mostly. I need to work back that way. So what I'm planning is to do this lot, this little section, up to where? About there. And then that'll fill the barrow. And take the barrow to the heap, make myself a coffee, and come back and carry on along there. First load. I'm not going to wait till it's... I've planned my route, so I know it's not a mounded barrow, but if it was, I'd still have a little bit to do, so I figure I'll do the other bit at the end and then I can carry on further. without having to go and empty. It's all in the great plan. Even the seagulls are sick of all the holiday makers. They've come inland. So what I did, I've got a coffee and I came back from this way because there's a, you know, apart from that little patch of sunlight there, it's mostly shade. So that's another thing you do, is to pick the areas of most shade and walk that way. And in hot countries, they just walk slower, do everything slower. Expect that's what you have to do. I've moved my workstation, hat and bag. I can't wear a hat all the time because the hat makes me too hot. So I have to reduce that. Now I'm trying to work out what I do here, because this is the meadow. What I'm thinking I might do is to, well, I've finished the other paddock. I mean, that's going to be so hot up in that top bit. Is I might go that way first. Well, in fact, I will. That's it, sorted. Yeah, I'm glistening. I can see my reflection in the screen behind me. Yeah, you can see the glistening. Well, that's going to catch the sun. Even if the sun wasn't out and it was sort of half cloud, you know, it would still catch it. So that's what means I have to be careful. But the hat produces more sweat, which, what do you do? I can't not work because I won't have any money. Yeah, I'm self-employed. So I've just got to pace myself, I suppose. It's quite nice here in the shade. Underneath the holm oak. You see the leaves turn to a nice crinkly. There you go. Lovely, isn't it? It's basically a cross between a holly and an oak. It's a holly oak. And that's where Hollyoak gets its name. Well, there are a few things in here that are lovely, like bitter nightshade. Bittersweet, I mean. Woody nightshade, another name. And look, we even have my favourite there, the green berries. Black bryony, and here's some more with its telltale leaves. Look, I love it. And also, look at these. Hopefully, it's going to be full, but we should be getting rain next week, apparently, which would help, but who knows. So that's it all done. The rest is going to be cut with a hedge cutter later on in the autumn. But I've just got any brambles that were coming over and would root. Now I did take some out from here that had rooted and become quite deep shrubs. Now I'm trying to work out whether to go down that hedge line and down the hedge there and just have a look. Yeah, I might do, because I don't think there's going to be much, but it would get me in the shade. And my coffee's still far too hot to drink, so I wouldn't be losing out in any way. So it would give it time to cool down a bit. It's a great mug, that. Just keeps everything so hot, even in winter. Sweet peas, scented lovely. Not doing that great, but they need far more water than they're getting. And courgettes looking fine too. Oh, have lots of them. And the noise you might be able to hear in the background, that's another combine harvester working the field. The harvest is really going for it this year. I think they've done more than ever, because I think they've cut hay as well. They've taken hay from fields where they don't normally cut. And because it's dry, there's so much dust in the air that, you know, it affects sinuses. So be aware of that wherever you live. Well, I've looked down there, that's pretty clear. So I've gone along the bottom and further round is exactly what I thought wasn't going to be there. The umbrella is useful because I can use it as a shade when I walk, and it allows air to get to the top of my head, which a hat doesn't do. So it's quite a useful thing. That's one of the things in my purple bag of stuff. And as you can see, I'm right here now. I'm by the gate of the first meadow that I was in. So I'm now here on this bit of fence working that way. Now, such is the laws of 3D life that I have the barrow behind the holm oak there. It's up into the next section of the grounds. Because I figured, well, I'm off round that way, that was my plan. I'll just quickly go here because I wasn't expecting much. But there's a lot of brambles coming out of this section of fence, and for the next sort of 5 or 6 metres along here. So, you know. So that's why I'm back here. And I've had to go and get all my stuff. But I'm just going to try. Now this is dock plantain, and this is the dock that you need to rub on stinging nettles. Now apparently, these seeds, they taste a bit like mushrooms. So I'm going to try one. And I can indeed report that they do taste like mushrooms. That's very nice. I like that. A bit of foraging in summer. About 2.5 hours and one coffee later, and we're done down here. That's all done. I haven't gone along the bottom. I'll have a quick look. It's probably just some nettles, and there's what we've already done. So it's time for a sandwich now. That sandwich was lovely. Now I'm at this end now, I haven't got far to go. Just there is the line, so there's just a little bit of bramble here. That section of green. And then we're done here. Now this really was a mass of them. That took me ages. It's taken me about half an hour, but it's quite free along here now. And I'm very warm, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk up that hedge line to the top and go through the gate and go and cool down. There's a trough up there so I can dip my hands in, my wrists in. And if that sounds strange to anyone, that's because cold water on your pulse points on your wrists or on your ankles will instantly cool your blood going to your heart. So you just then instantly cool down. It's really good. So I use it quite a lot. What I probably should have done is bring some ice blocks. You know, those camping ice things for that you can get to put inside cooler boxes and stuff. And then bring them with me so I can rub them on my wrists for even more instanter cooling. Sure, they only last for so long, but I'm not quite sure. I'll have to experiment. Maybe I'll bring one and see. It's always worth a try, isn't it? So I'll report on that at a future date. I'm still kill steeping. I'm still keeping in the shade. I'm probably full of dripping sweats, but what I'm going to do is, while I'm in the shade, see these? They're hogweed, so we don't want them spreading into that beautiful arena. So I'm going to do those as well as any brambles that I find. So I thought I have to take all my stuff in stages because I need to have an umbrella or a hat. There you go. Now that's let's take them. So here we go. I think I'll start on those. There's two there. Drop the tools in the spot I need them. Come and get my second coffee, my hat and my water. Shut the gate. Shut the gate. Am I coming down this way? Yeah, I probably will. I will. Yeah. Okay. I, you know, even putting my sunglasses on my head, they just get steamed up. Light and shade makes a really good shot, doesn't it? You know, even if there are gates and fences. Here we are above the second paddock, or probably the far paddock. Oh, look at hogweed down there. But, I thought I was going to get a shot of the combine for you. I know it's not exciting for many people, but I'm just trying to show you all the angles. So here's what I've got here with the incredible string bag. Really useful. I never believed. I mean, I never knew that string bags would be so handy. I want some more. I need one for shopping, another for work, another for going filming. They're useful. They're so brilliant. Unbelievable. So you can see I'm doing hogweed out of the lower bit of the meadow while it's in shade. You know, because we don't want to ruin the Queen Anne's lace. But, you know, we've got it down, like constant weeding. Not constant weeding, regular doing of it, going round a few times a year and just cutting all the hogweed flowers. You know, it's worth spending a day doing it. Because you get them out of areas where you don't want them. And if you want to risk it, you can eat them. Check out how first. And also the nettles. See, we don't want nettles growing in certain areas. I mean, nettles are a sign that everything, the area is fertile. But we don't want them to grow in certain places. We've got them in the woods, we've got them in certain margins, so, you know, the red admirals can... Is it the red admirals or peacocks? All the insects that need them can find them. But we just want them away from certain areas that are like, you know, wildflower meadows and stuff. Now, I'm wondering if they're going to... I mean, there is a... I just had a thought today about, you know... about making an area, setting an area aside and just letting it go and see what happens. So yeah, so just over 4 hours I've done so far. I don't do whole days, not in weather like this, because it could kill me. Literally, it could kill me. So. I think that's about it, really. Let's see if I can take you up here. Just a little way through Anne. Queen Anne. Why it's called Queen Anne's Lace, I don't know, but lush, isn't it? Gert lush, isn't it? I don't know if the young deer is still in here. I suspect he is. Well, there's all the dust. I sneezed from back there. Luckily, they were just coming along here. So luckily, I was able to escape the worst. So my timing's good. I just got to get past this field now. So thanks for watching and see you next time. Ta-da.